Welcome back, everybody, to USA Rugby TV and the USA Rugby Fall Collegiate Championships. I'm Alex Goff from Goff Rugby Report. Alongside me is Katie Wurst, USA Rugby coach educator. And Katie, we have here the women's Division II final between Davenport and Winona State. And we're talking a little bit about how these teams got here. They both played yesterday. Davenport coming back from a 26-5 deficit at halftime. They use their power, and there's Moreland, the number 8. What a big, powerful runner she is, and that long 8-man pick was a part of a huge, stirring comeback in the second half, setting up Ordwain for the try. But a great second half for Davenport.
They certainly have a great deal of range here, as you see Burge with the finesse going. She absolutely hands off a player there, too. A nice little move to get through. They were just scoring threats all day.
Well, we've kicked off here, and Winona State is in the mostly white jerseys with Davenport in the red. Davenport out of Grand Rapids, Michigan. Winona State, the champions out of Minnesota. And already we've got Davenport looking to perhaps exert their physical dominance. That was one of the things they didn't really do in the first half against Bloomsburg. They had it, they just didn't use it, and fell behind by 21 points, but then scored, I think the final score, 43-26, they were dominant in the second half. So first call of the day is a penalty against Davenport, offside, and the kick to touch from the fly half. Catherine Dries, who was part of the 2013 national championship team, and Dries gets it to touch. Davenport, you gotta look, watch out for Moreland, that number 8. Ashley Burge, really that playmaker at number 10, and Katie Daniel Ordway, tries all over the place. 5 tries yesterday.
Yep, they call her Dash as well. Just certainly has been scampering all over the pitch this whole weekend long. Just a really dangerous threat here for this Davenport team.
And already Winona going to Lenora Duhart, their prop forward, their number 1 ground gainer. She takes the tap penalty. She does pretty much everything. Bucky now playing blindside flanker. She's been a lock as well for Winona State. She goes forward, but knocked back again in the tackle. Another penalty. A little bit of a chat. Let's keep the penalties down. Saw a great number of ruck penalties throughout the day yesterday. And Katie, I don't know if that's interpretation. Is it the fact that these players are really ramping up the physicality at the point of contact? I'm not sure what it is.
It is about just, this is the top level of play here too. Sometimes aggression and just the energy level that it takes to get here gets people a little bit fun finding these sort of aggressive penalties, which aren't necessarily the most dangerous thing early on, but they can come back to haunt you later.
We're looking at that midfield of Winona State, Wolf and Esters, very, very dangerous at 12 and 13. And Bucky, a good open field runner as a forward. Somebody to watch for Winona State Black Cats.
Now to tapped in on just an interesting sort of lineup change here. Bucky was so dangerous in the lineouts from the lock positions. Now slid over to play flanker for this Black Cats team.
And Lenora Duhart at number 3, the prop forward. Important in tight, but she's an open field player as well, can pass well. So scrum down to Davenport.
Another interesting development for the Black Cats is Courtney Kovanasek, who was missing yesterday. She's a USA Rugby U20 member, too, stepping in to play that lock position. Some interesting tactical decisions in terms of getting the team right. Coach Josh Krasinski looking to use all of the different weapons that he has at his advantage.
So another penalty, this time to Davenport. They're going to kick to touch. Good touch finder, a little bit conservative, but they've got to get that line out set up for Davenport. It'll be an important throw in, but the penalty coming down at scrum time. Get that put in ready, but there's so much of a battle going on there. Winona State not able to hold that shove. Line out comes to Winona's side, and that's Hill, the scrum half, getting it moving, trying to use Dries and Wolf and Esters. And there's Esters breaking it out there. Esters has got all kinds of green, but nobody else with her. So she tries to get by, taken down by O'Connor. The Winona State support is there. And ball comes back out.
Lake and a hard charging runner from Boscobel, Wisconsin.
And that looks like Bucky in there again. Penalty against Davenport. And they're gonna go quickly. And this is Duhart. Duhart kind of running slowly, but she's not going down. Takes three or four players to get her down. So the Black Cats trying to get that ball out, try to use that momentum they have. Out we come. Dries to Wolf, Esters, all the way out to the right wing, and Kron had it, but forward pass.
And we talked about really just the hyper-intensity around these playoffs in terms of this is the championship match. We have a tendency to get just a little bit too ahead of the pass. One thing, you just have to calm those nerves, take a couple of deep breaths, and just focus on some things that went well yesterday and bring them into this game.
Well, you see how they can break through just like they can with Moreland, the number 8 for Davenport. This was from yesterday. This was that try that they had going, setting up Ordwain. But you got to watch out for that quick strike ability from Winona State as well. So,
Davenport's so dominant in terms of scrummaging all day yesterday against Bloomsburg, making some adjustments. Winona stepping up to the challenge.
The kick by Burge. Great playmaker, but a great kick too. It takes a Davenport roll. And there's the fullback. And that was Schultz setting up Kron. Kron didn't have much room to go, and Burge was following up on her kick. Nice tackle. And Katie, I'm very impressed with the number 10 for Davenport, Ashley Burge. She's just a sophomore. She's from Utah, and she's got all kinds of skill.
Yeah, she certainly recently spent time at the Olympic Training Center with the Women's Eagles as well. Just getting back from Dubai. She's also a 2-time collegiate All-American. Has been involved with pretty much every level of the player development pathway.
A little bit of a balk throw there from Medzelic, and in the end, it's a not straight. And they're gonna take the line out now for Winona State. The throw-in is actually from the scrum half here, Kayleen Hill. And it's kind of a low throw, but Black Cats secure it. Set the ruck. The pass, not really to anyone, and towed ahead by Wolf. And as a result, lost. That looks like Burge, again, just struggling through that contact. Where is the pass going? Brown, such an impact player yesterday. But they've lost it in contact. Winona State has it now. That's Kovanich, the lock forward. Out we come again. Bucky clearing out. So is Jurger. And it looks like Duhart has it, picked it up and goes ahead. Another pick and go. And Katie, I'm not sure if this is the way to get through Davenport, but it seems to be working at the moment as Kovanich goes again.
Certainly going with the game plan to try to pull in the defense as much as they can. Davenport's taking the bait.
Again, Duhart. Hill puts it out there to Wolf. Wolf to Esters. Esters breaks a tackle. Esters almost through again. It's there to be used. Wolf, first receiver. She's got Kron with her, but that's pretty much it. DeMars clears out. Duhart off to Kron, and once again, Emily Kron has got to be thinking, would you please give me the ball with a little bit of space? She has about half a foot between herself and the sideline, and so, really, not the way you want to set up your wings.
Well, credit to Kron for really maintaining her composure, doing what she can with a little bit of space, working with it. But the person who's who's having a lot of go-forward ball to happen is Lenore Duhart, another collegiate All-American. Just a workhorse all day yesterday. Was pretty much everywhere on the pitch. Fantastic effort, too. Taking a minute now to just tend to an injury.
Well, while we have a player down on the field, I want to remind you, BLK is the fastest growing teamwear supplier in the world, is proud to be the official apparel partner of USA Rugby. Visit BLKSport.com to see how BLK can assist you and your team to go beyond limits known. BLK, it's not change, it's evolution. And Katie, what we saw yesterday out of the Winona State team was that when they got secure ball, when they were able to set a platform for their backs, they were able to use players like Lakin Esters and like Megan Wolf. And here, this is the work with Ashley Burge.
And see, just a great runner there, too. Uses a little misdirection, a nice pass over the shoulder as well to Daniel Ordway, who's just such a speedster. She always seems to be in the right position.
And here's the back line for Winona State, wriggling out of trouble, Dries and Esters, and working their way with Hannigan and Cron to set up a try in the back line.
And here's just another look to it. That was Lenore Duhart, as we said, just fantastic work, such an evasive player too. And that's Esters, just such a great finisher for this Black Cats team. Just has a fantastic nose for the try line, gets herself where she needs to be.
And that was in Winona State's victory over Vassar. And
we're still taking a minute to just tend to an injured player. Safety considerations, always priority number one here. And you can also hear from national team coaches and top-level rugby administrators from around the world at 2016 USA Rugby National Development Summit in San Francisco. You can learn best practices at this can't-miss event the weekend of January 22nd. Register now at usarugby.org/NDS. Just a fantastic event there, Alex. Really, you can learn so much. There's a range of information from medical care and coverage, as we're seeing attended to right now, to referee development, coach development as well. As we take a look here at Davenport, taking a minute just to collect their thoughts.
Referee development is really an important aspect of the game. And, you know, it's one of those things where if you don't like your officiating in your local league, well, you need to do something about it. Especially if you can try and get young people into refereeing, it can really just get them started early. We need young athletic referees, and certainly we need young athletic referees who have a little bit of experience playing Type 5 rugby as well, because of the demands of the game. And we have a good young core of referees here at these championships. Khalil Harrison is our referee today for this game with John Stevens, who's my roommate for the weekend, and Emily Grambush as the assistants. As player is raised up and about to be taken off, looks like a leg injury, and it's been a while to taken a while for them to take care and make sure that she's all right to be able to be assisted off. And I actually don't have a number. I'm not sure, Katie, if you saw a number on that player. And so it's number four, the lock forward, Bailey Jurger. And that'll be a blow for Winona State in terms of taking off a tight five player, but they do have some depth there.
It could be an interesting mix here with Jurger out. Potentially Bucky could slot back into that lock position, did so well there yesterday. So Coach Krasinski having to make a couple of different tactical substitutions at this point.
And they're bringing on Cheyenne Messer in as a sub. She's not going in the lineout right now. Caught. Lineout throw caught by Carrie Jordan. Criminal justice major. Out and out, Audries. And in there to Wolf. Wolf, the experienced inside center for the Black Cats. And Hill digs it out again. Trying to get that moving along the wing to Kavanich, but again, not enough space there, a little bit too sideways. And once more, Winona State pushed into touch.
Kovanich, a nursing and Spanish major too, as we said, a U-20 team member, but also a collegiate academic honor roll recipient as well.
You see how Jordan just grabbed that loose ball and immediately just put her head down and went for it. Nice kick from Burge. Again, a good rolling kick taken by the fullback, Schultz. Schultz right down on the ground from Burge. Again, impressed with that fly half for Davenport, but out it comes for Winona State. Dries and Wolf and Esters. Esther is tackled, no one with her, and it is stolen nicely by Taffel, the wing for Davenport, and the ball is not coming out of that ruck, and it'll be a scrum down to Davenport.
Match official allowed advantage to go along right there, and then brought it back for the scrum. Davenport was able to gather possession of the ball quickly and then brought it back.
Well, isolated runners is a problem, Katie, and we've seen that through the weekend. Players going on a break, but they're in their local leagues, they're probably used to breaking through a few more tackles and getting through, and their support runners are used to those runners breaking through tackles and getting through, and so you don't really just get on your horse and follow on.
It certainly was an issue for Davenport yesterday in the first half. They just had a lot of sort of individual runs, and they needed support to come forward. Definitely made corrections in the second half.
Well, two sloppy things, one for each side, and Davenport ends up rescuing that one. Ferguson, flanker for Davenport. She's a big ground gainer for them. She goes forward. Burge now, the fake, and the long loopy pass out to the wing, and that'll be Taffel.
You mentioned Ferguson has a trial coming up for the All-American team as well, too. She's certainly proven herself, done some exceptional work here for Davenport. Really just has a great work rate and a really hard-charging runner.
She's an excellent runner of the ball, and I don't know, I kind of see her maybe with a number 2 on her jersey rather than a number 7 as she goes up to the upper echelon. Davenport has a tight 5 based on strength, not necessarily on mobility, but we do have to acknowledge that they finished pretty nicely yesterday. So
one of those players that has both size and mobility is Hunter Moreland as well. We saw her in that beautiful 8-map pick move and then connecting with her backs.
And the ball goes to the tail end. It is won by Winona State. Nicely rucked over. And you see the head down. And stolen by Davenport. Burge once again. But taken away this time by Duhart. And you see that Kovanich is getting involved, trying to get forward, offloading. But that offload didn't go to hand and it went down to the ground. So we've got another scrum. 13 minutes into this game and there's no score, and in fact, Katie, we haven't even been close to seeing a score. It's been a game that's camped out right in the middle of the field.
Well, we certainly knew that this would be a clash of titans here in the collegiate women's circuit, and they're just fantastically really putting a great deal of phases together from both sides and then converting back and forth. Here's Davenport with that dominating scrum that we've seen.
Big shove, and now they're using their backs. Wolf. Excuse me, not Wolf, that would be Tennant trying to set up Ordway.
Credit to Burge for saving that ruck right there.
Ferguson again, going with Moreland on her hip. Moreland takes the offload. Quick ball.
That's Midzelic actually with that hard charging run forward.
Thank you, Katie, Midzelic.
She also is another All-American prospect as well.
And there is Overbeek, another big, powerful player. That's the hooker, bigger than most props you'll see in collegiate rugby. And there's a big run there by the lock forward, Donahue. Burge wants it. She's got Ferguson. Ferguson shows and cuts back, but they saw that coming all the way. Burge again, looking to use Ordway. Back inside to Tennant, who takes a clock around the ponytail. A low pass, a little bit of a rush there. Referee says no knock on, came off the boot. So again, slow going, getting that ball out, and very static at this point. And Katie, you've got to say that this Winona State team is making their tackles.
They certainly are. I think that was Cashie Schultz on that tackle. It was a little bit high too, but certainly had an impact on the ground. And so just popped that ball loose.
You see the cover defense on Moreland's break as she takes the offload from Ferguson. And quick ball, and this was what their more promising opportunities, but that terrific tackle around the ankles by Samantha Wilcox, number 8. That was the one that took down the prop, Midzelic, and perhaps saved some serious problems for Winona State.
What you saw on the other side of the ball, too, was Brown right in there in support as well, something that, again, they struggled with a bit early on yesterday and have so far made some great corrections, leading to a much better start for this Davenport Panthers team. It's great field position here for Davenport. And a great platform that they've built. They certainly do take scrummaging seriously up there in Grand Rapids.
Well, foot was up a little bit early, and in fact, Davenport is a little bit fortunate to get just the ball out of the tunnel because Overbeek was ready to strike before that ball was in.
You see Winona making a couple adjustments there too. Really, it's about, you know, regardless of size, what it is, it's just body position and good core strength. These are exactly the tools you need if you're going up against an opponent that has you in size.
Kerry Jordan, Hannah DeMars, and Lenora Duhart, the front row for Winona State. Karen Brown, Veronica Overbeek, and Allison Midzelinik for Davenport. Telescan puts it in. Moreland picks it up. Moreland's going through. Does she have support? She is taken down. Ferguson clears out. Burge now out to Tennant. Tennant can't get the handle, though. And it'll be a knock-on. And, Katie, that was all just a case of get it in your hands and hold on to it, and maybe we got a try coming.
Certainly. She saw the space in front of her, and it happens so often with all levels of play. As you start to see that try line, you're getting closer. Take your eyes off the ball for the last second, and that's when those knock-ons start to happen. But fortunately for Davenport, they're awarded a scrum, which has been something they've been doing quite well.
And that scrum gets that go forward, gets that platform. Moreland able to make that 8-man pick. Going on the open side, forcing Catherine Dries, the fly half, to tackle her, which she did do. So the Black Cats, the put in. But look at that shove. Davenport able to put the shove on, but not able to get the ball. Referee calls it back. Referee Harrison calls it back for a scrum infraction. Oh, using the hands to rescue that ball. That's some risky work in the scrum to release your hand out and bring it down. You can do it. And you see how the scrum shove here, Katie, was so dominant from Davenport. And Winona State seemed to come out with it in the end.
And that was Nadia Nassov that picked up the ball too, showing some good pace. Unfortunately, they brought it back. We've seen a number of scrum infractions. It really is what starts to happen. It makes you buckle mentally when you're being dominated and going backwards all game.
And that will set up a penalty attempt for the Panthers. And the kick from Hannah Tennant is up, but it is away. And the referee is going to have a little bit of a chat with the assistant referees.
It was a good decision in theory, not necessarily execution there. To get points early, since we said we've really almost no opportunities for scoring so far, so if anything's afforded, it's a good thing to take on.
And so we'll have the 22 dropout for Winona State. And this is all about points, isn't it? And the kick is deep. It's caught nicely by Taffel. And the pick and go, the first pick and go from the Panthers. Good solid clear out there from Ferguson. And now they're using their forwards to get through that second channel. You saw Overbeek get over the ball. Berge using her forwards. Tennant taken down. But Medzelic rescuing that. Berge again tries to get past Duhart. Duhart has her.
Such a difficult challenge to get past Duhart all game.
Ferguson taken down by Nassif. Tennant now, first receiver, pops it out to the lock. Jory Smith. But they've lost it in that ruck, and that was nicely secured by Winona State. And suddenly, turnover ball. Great chance here for Esters. Esters fakes it. Esters goes up the middle. And Lakin Esters is just dragged down by Catherine O'Connor. A lot of upright bodies here as it took a while for them to get all the way down that field. But now we've got Kavanich. Kavanich trying to send it out wide. Maybe Hannigan can get there, Rachel Hannigan. But not the best pass in the world and ends up being knocked forward. And Katie, just a little bit of skill breakdown at key moments.
You saw some good defensive chase there, too, from Berge as well. This Davenport team just holding on. You see much more line breaks or great things working for the Black Cats, but Davenport really just getting it done defensively.
There, Lakin Esters, the number 12. That little bit of a fake out to the right wing, out to Emily Cron, and then just come back inside. Esters has been good. The Boscobel, Wisconsin native, really had a good weekend. And so scrum to Davenport. Telescan gets it out. Berge, good kicker. She doesn't ask too much of her kicks. She knows she can kick a nice line drive that'll roll, and she tends to do that, and that kick is gives a bit of a breathing room for Davenport. Still no score here, about midway through the first half here in this Division II fall final here at Furman University. I'm Alex Goff with Katie Wurst. And Katie, is this what you expected? No score midway through the first half?
Absolutely, Alex. Just such a great contest and two teams that are really interesting, tell different stories about their strengths, and they're all both using them today.
Duhart is the first time we've really seen her move, and Bucky sends it out to Wolf. Wolf is trying to go for the corner, but she is dragged down nicely by Francis. And Francis and O'Connor wanted to get on that ball quickly, but they went too quickly down on the ball. Referee Harrison says that's a penalty. And so Duhart says, you know, why don't we just tap this and run?
You saw Duhart scamper after that ball quickly and come back and then take a moment, which was a really good indicator of poise. Let's set up some sort of set play, see what we can do here.
Hill. Oh, they set up a wall. We might be going for the old up the jumper move, and they pass it off to Nassif. Nadia Nassif, the open side flanker. Something out of the playbook from back in the early 80s, I think. Liked it. Samantha Wilcox, the number 8. She tries to weave her way through. Another pick and go. This time Kavanich. She's just dragged down near the corner. Another pickup. Oh, they're very close now. Referee's right there making sure Davenport doesn't infringe. And in the end, it is grabbed and taken back over the line and touchdown by Davenport. And that will be a scrum 5 for Winona State. Katie, not sure if we've got enough room for an 8-man pick around the right side, but Winona State exerting the pressure.
Going up again, a formidable scrummage from this Panthers team as well, too. So thinking about getting the ball quick, let the backs who took you there get the job done, see if they can finish.
Catherine Dries standing off for Winona State. Well, Wilcox has to do a lot of work to try and rescue that ball at the back of the scrum. Does enough. Dries, Esters, Dries on the loop. Wolf getting the fullback. Schultz in the line. She goes to the try line, dishes it off, and try Winona State.
That looked like Rachel Hannigan, I think that was. Just a wing out there. As we said, make sure you can spread the ball wide. They had plenty of space to work with. Davenport just wasn't able to get across there. Credit for protecting that ball from the number eight as well, Wilcox.
Nassif did the clear out, and there was the loop move. And then Schultz in there. She's tackled, but just as she's tackled, able to drop it off to Rachel Hannigan. And finally, a wing able to run onto the ball and get a little bit of room. And first blood to Winona State, 5-0. And Katie, Davenport's been in this situation before. They were behind in the first half yesterday and picked it up. And the message then was patience, patience. Let's just run the game plan, use the forwards to put a stranglehold on this. But I'm impressed with Winona State's forwards as the kick is away and remains 5-0. The Black Cat forwards are meeting Davenport in the loose.
Certainly. The difference is about the sustainability of the attack, which we can certainly expect from the Black Cats. Winona State just known for working that game plan quite well, too. And we've seen a differential with Davenport today, too. Certainly much more up for this first half today. Again, such a great contest we have here so far.
So what can Davenport do to reply? What they would like to do, chase under this kick and try to put in a few hits, but it's taken very well by Hannigan, the try scorer. And now the confidence seems to start flowing from the Winona State team. What they were doing was working. Quick tap now, and out to Kavanich, but she's just driven back.
That was Ordway on that driving tackle. Fantastic leg drive.
And so out to Burge. Burge is met, but slips out of it. Long, wide pass, Tennant. Schultz, excuse me, O'Connor trying to clear out there from fullback. Francis is in there, the wing. Max getting involved in those rucks. Ferguson, the flanker. Clear out by Medzelic. Burge now again. Tennant. Not really anywhere to go as Esther's kind of corrals her. But Telescan gets it out again. Ordway. Ordway, so dangerous in open field. She's able to dish it off. But look at that counter ruck from Winona State. They almost stole it. Still Davenport. A lot more urgency now. A lot more physicality in the breakdown. They've got numbers on the outside. Ferguson doesn't seem to pass it too much. She just goes straight up ahead. And she would have been perhaps better off to pass it to Brown, because Brown had Melissa Francis, the left wing, kind of all alone there on the left.
We saw some great defensive things there, too, from the Black Cats. Just great low body position in that counter ruck earlier, too. Also saw a saddle roll to get the player off. But Ferguson, so dangerous. They got the ball off just in time. Just probably wasn't looking for support. Make that quick adjustment, and they're off for try scoring.
Good tackle on Ferguson to force that knock on. So it is a scrum to Winona State, but we should expect Davenport to put on a good shove.
The key for Winona State really has been to combat the size of Davenport is getting low in the tackles. They're doing a great job of that. They're sighting the target and sticking the shoulders in and getting it done.
Moreland, they've stolen it. It's a tight head. Moreland picks it up, the number eight. She goes, she's over. And that was all about the shove, initial shove as the ball was put in. Then they're able to steal it. Overbeek's able to hook it back, and Moreland picks it up, goes left, takes three people over with her.
Spoke a bit too soon about that tackling right there. Moreland really just making it so difficult. Good shove, great pickup. There's one missed tackle, two. Just trying up around the shoulders, you've got to get lower. But Moreland, such a formidable runner. She just absolutely owns that space at the back of the scrum and a great weapon for the Panthers.
And if you can't get low, get in front of her so when she touches down, your body is underneath that ball. Tennant with the conversion attempt, and it is up, it is good, and Davenport replies exactly what we talked about. What's the reply? The reply is very impressive, and Davenport is now ahead 7-5.
And Davenport really just riding the back of that great scrum platform they have to utilizing their forwards. It's really about a power game here for them, but they certainly have some dangerous backs that can run too. This is a critical next couple of minutes here for Winona to see how they can answer back.
And the kick, long, deep one. And a nice little return there from Taffel. And the forwards again from Davenport.
Nice defensive launch there from the Black Cats.
And that was Burge trying to go a little bit around to the right side. I'm not sure if that was going to work for them. And in fact, they've lost the ball. Not a great option, and it works out nicely for Winona State. Esters again. Come tackle me, she says. There's a scrum half. Kayleen Hill trying to snipe around the left side. One more surge. Good clear out from several Winona State forwards. And again, the pick and the go. Looks like there might have been Kavanich. And the pick and go again.
A great control drive here from Winona State.
And then we've got Dries trying to set up Esters for Wolf. Wolf is all alone. Oh, she pops it up. That was exactly what she needed to do because there was no one there. Nadia Nassif's coming around like a good number seven, but it just bounced off her torso and onto the ground, so there'll be a knock-on by Winona State. But some better continuity, Katie, from Winona State.
Certainly, Nassif just looked like her hands weren't quite ready to make that pass, wasn't anticipating that it was coming to her. But great position. Good job kind of getting in support there. Davenport will take another scrum. Critical to make sure defensively that you can get off and block off whatever's going on with that eight-man pick, which has been dangerous so far.
The scrum seems to be owned by Davenport at this point. Tellers can ready to put it in for Davenport. Again, got a little bit of discussion here about the cadence and the timing of the hit. You get that first hit in, something they've been trying to guard against the whole battle about getting in there first. Referee's supposed to just ease everybody together, but still there's an advantage to the angle, especially if you're overpowered.
That's Khalil Harrison there. Winona State trying to do what they can to sort of manage this. You'll see that a lot when one team's dominant. They'll be starting to do some a little bit different types of techniques or something that they can do just to maintain ball possession.
So now 7 minutes left in this first half. Division II final for women. Winona State scored first. It was a backline break and a backline try at the end of it. They've stolen that scrum. That was just poorly controlled by Davenport. The run from Bucky. And Bucky is tackled, and Bucky tried to say, well, I'm not held in the tackle, so I'm going to get back up. And we see a lot of players try and play that game with referees, but she was held in the tackle. So as she stood up, that's holding on. But the kick does not go to touch. It's fielded nicely by Hannigan, who dishes it off. Black Cats back on the attack. Hill digging for it. Dries, Esters, Wolf looking for Kron. Kron hasn't had much room. Well, she gets a little bit there. She is taken down by Francis. And once again, Davenport quick on the ball in the ruck. And Winona State making the error.
So quick, they actually looked to have been rucked off their own player at that point. We'll bring it back a minute two for that ball stolen against the head by Winona State, starting to sort out this mystery that is the Davenport scrum. looking to utilize more quickness, getting the ball in quick. When you're moving backwards, it's about as short amount of time as you possibly can stay in that scrum, and then get off to the races.
The line-out has been a little bit of a mystery as well. Execution in that. And that one worked out very nicely for the Panthers. They've got it going now. Burge takes a run herself, had Ferguson with her. And they dig it out. And they look to use Donahue. Donahue breaking through again. The lock forward. Dragged down by the other lock, Winona State lock, Kovanich, and dragged into touch. A little laugh between the two players. And Duhart helps Donahue up off the ground. But well, there you see Donahue puts the ball into the other hand, switches it again to make the fend. She does that a couple of times. Really good awareness of how she has to hold that ball and how she has to use her free hand.
Brenna Donahue, a great example of the mobility that this Panthers group does have in their forward pack.
And Ferguson put into the back line, and the flanker goes, runs, runs, runs. She dishes it off, and that is Ordway. Ordway not all the way, as Taffel is there on her hip. Forward slow to get there. In fact, most of them not there. Davenport's tight five is all in the back line, in fact. That is your entire back line. Tight five players. Can they pass it? Well, look at that handling. Fantastic handling and passing out to the one back in the back line, Melissa Francis. And that is a try. And you look at who they had out there in the backs. Overbeak, the hooker. She passes out to Medzelic, who juggles it a little bit, gets it to Brown, and out to the left wing. Look at that juggling around. But when you don't have a lot of speed, get it to your speed player, Francis, who gets in there just as Duhart tries to tackle her in the corner.
Quite an impressive pass for length there, too, from Brown as well. Just good, unselfish play. She certainly could have just put her head down and bowled over the line, but saw it was a much easier job there to get it wide. Great work try there.
And Katie, that's one of those great lessons from four tight five players. We talk about how if you've got the ball and you're not sure what to do, well, put your head down and go forward, and that's true, but be aware of what you've got around you. And there, obviously they've done some handling drills and some handling practice in training, even as prop forwards, and that helps them. And look at this, the way they just thought about it. That's what they were going to do. They were going to pass it along and out to the wing.
You also see defensive range, too, there from Duhart chasing down the wing from the prop position. Great example of effort. Certainly a great player for the Black Cats. Just has a motor that keeps going all game long.
Well, with that try, the conversion is missed. 12-5 Davenport. They fell behind 5-0, and they've answered with two tries since then. We have about 2 minutes left in this first half, and we've seen a variety of skills by Davenport. We can see the forwards can do something when they're in the back line. It would have been interesting to see had Winona State been able to turn that ball over, because we would have seen the quite speedy Lakin Esters and Megan Wolf up against front row players. That might have been a problem for the Panthers, but in the end they scored. Knock forward in contact by Davenport, and it'll be a scrum to Winona State. One last shot, perhaps, at scoring before the halftime whistle.
So much talent on both of these sides, Alex. 1 through 15 across the board. Really great to see such range as well, too. We're seeing props make long seven-style passes. We're seeing backs ruck. It's just an exceptional job. There's so much leg drive, too, at any position, and just a testament to the top quality level of collegiate women's rugby we're seeing in these playoffs.
Big shove by Davenport again. But it's kicked out nicely by Wilcox and Hill. And now we do a loop move. And it's man and ball. Ordway forces the knock on. And Burge. Burge fakes it. Burge goes through. She doesn't have anybody with her, really. But she is able to set the ball back just enough Davenport still has control of it.
Great identification of a gap there by Burge. He just saw the space and went for it.
Good clear up by O'Connor, the fullback, and then moving it again, Ordway. A student body right, it looks like. And a massive hit there from the center, Esters. And still the pressure comes from Davenport. The ball squirts out of the side of the ruck. And that'll be a knock-on by Winona State. We are right on the edge of this first half. 12-5 Davenport leads. We've got possibly one more shot here. You look at the way Esters meets that contact, Katie. Really nice, hard, legal tackle.
Certainly took her for an elevator ride there, too. Up to the second floor. Check out Sporting Goods.
But didn't drop her down off the third floor, which was important to make sure she landed on her backside and not on her head.
Yeah, as you said, a very legal tackle, too. Good shoulder contact, leg drive. The key being that she went to the man, too, not catching the tackle. Just a great effort there. Esther, such a well-rounded player defensively, a formidable tackler, but has been making line breaks all day as well, too.
Ball came straight out of the tunnel. It's about the 90th time that's happened this half, it seems. A huge battle between the hookers, trying to get a little bit of an advantage. And there's Moreland picking up, going weak. Nice clear out, and everybody ready to go. Brown. Doesn't get a lot of speed going, but she doesn't go down easily. Burge now picks it up. She waits. She didn't like that. And she waited for the longer pass to Tennant. Ordway got it, but they've got her lined up. Wolf and Ordway. Nice little battle going on there. Overbeek. The ruck over by Winona State. They've got it. Duhart. She's got it.
Fantastic counter ruck there by the Black Hats. Duhart picking up the ball.
Kron. Poor Kron. Again, no room. She's taken down. Touch. Judge flag goes up, and that is the end of the first half. We will be right back after a break here. Davenport leads 12-5 in this Women's Division II final. Thank you. All right, we are back here at the USA Rugby Fall Collegiate Championships. This is Alex Goff from Goff Rugby Report with USA Rugby coach educator Katie Wurst. And halftime here with Davenport as we look at the highlights from the first half. Winona State drew blood first.
Lenora Duhart caught that off. It was just such a fantastic job. It's a good distribution of the ball here. This was that great, well-worked team try that ended up with Rachel Hannigan doing the honors to touch it down.
And they worked a nice loop with the fly half, Catherine Dries, and using their fullback too. But then there was that steal of the scrum right under the post. And Katie, we knew the scrum was going to be strong, and Moreland a tough nut to crack on the eight-man pick.
This is a beautiful thing, seeing a couple of props work the ball wide to the wing, who's finishing it, Duhart chasing down too. Just look at that slow-mo execution. Good job there. Handling it, a wraparound tackle there too, fighting to keep possession of the ball. And then she's got support there to get right over it.
Two teams that are used to scoring very high score lines, 80 points, 90 points. 12-5 here at halftime. Big hits, good defense.
That was Donahue taking that restart too. Doing well to keep the ball in.
And there's Ferguson. Michaela Ferguson. Their flanker and their chief runner. And I think at some point they're going to realize Winona State that she doesn't pass off too often. They're just going to go and get her. Another run from Jory Smith, but Winona State steals it. They end up being offside, but you see the aggression over the ruck, over the ball, and each collision, I'm going to have to call them collisions because they're not just tackles. They are trying to meet them face-to-face and knock them backward.
Jory Smith, another player that's been contributing a couple of great meters, really coming through when she's needed. Also a three-time national champion cheerleader. Probably no stranger to some tough hits.
I tell you what. When I coached girls rugby, I loved having cheerleaders on the team. They took coaching very well. They were athletic and had a high pain threshold.
Absolutely.
Worked very hard. So
it's just one of those great things about the crossover athletes coming into our sport.
Yeah.
They're getting thrown in the air, doing all these different acrobatic moves. So certainly beneficial to her to be in the lineout.
Ball comes loosely out of the lineout and it dribbles over touch, and it's going to be a lineout to Davenport. And you know, talking about cheerleaders, shout out to a former player of mine, Kelsey Stockard, who's played for the national team. She's a former cheerleader. I remember going to see a high school football game in my hometown, and out she came, cheerleader for Capital High School. So it happens at the highest levels. Ball stolen by Winona State, but the call is not straight. Call is numbers, I think. Well, that was a little bit of an interesting call because Winona State had the ball, so if the call was against them.
Referee Harrison taking a minute to have a conversation with Duhart there. Such a great leader for Winona State.
And that's a little bit of an odd one because Winona State gets the throw in, and yet they had won that ball. So I guess everybody's understanding what's going on. I'm not sure I am. Kayleen Hill
throws it
in. Nicely taken by the Black Tats. And look at that ripoff by Kavanich. Kavanich still going. She's got attention, but she's got a little bit of support. Tries to offload. The offload is good, but then knocked forward by Davenport and ends up being a scrum to Winona State. But some really nice running skills there from Courtney Kavanich, the former USA under 20 team member. And look at her just sort of stretch her legs. She needed to fend off Melissa Francis a little bit better, and she might have been all the way in, but in the end managed to keep that play alive just for a few seconds.
You saw the great defensive work too for them to just get a hold, where all she could do is make a one-handed pass, which is much lower percentage in terms of completion. But credit to Nazia Nassif to get there. Okay, certainly turned on the gas, and then just had the ball pop off of her teammate.
Hill rescues that. Dries rescues that pass. And then Esters thumped down to the ground by Tennant. And again, the hits are hard. Davenport has it. The pick and go, this time by Burge. Now we come again with the forwards for Davenport. Smith. Oh, the big thundering run from Mazalek. Brown wants it. You see the toll those runs are taking on the Winona State defense, but they do hold on to it. And in fact, force that knock on. Overbeek was in there as well.
You've just seen Mazalek, Brown, and Overbeek really just bringing the pain all game long, charging up field, really making zero attempt to do anything around getting through around them, just going through.
Well, with Mazalek being a medical assistant major, she can trample you and then take care of you after she's done it. Veronica Overbeek is a freshman coming in at hooker. They lost their starting hooker yesterday to an injury, but have seemed to handle it pretty well. The ball has come out the side of the scrum, rescued by Talisman, but it's going to be a penalty, binding infraction by the Davenport pack, and they really don't need to do that. They've been so strong in the scrum.
Pretty critical penalty here, too. Oh, unfortunate, just missed that kick. Could have got a little extra length there. Just went off the wrong part of the foot.
Yeah, I think she was looking at where she was kicking rather than looking at the ball she was putting the boot to. So a line out for Winona State, but really not much of a gain, maybe 2 or 3 meters. The throw in from Hill. The scrum half from Houston, Minnesota. Childhood education major. Now she's skating out wide, links directly with Esters. Esters again goes in. She goes in so high, though, she's being knocked back. Wolf. Now what can she do? Drops it off to Schultz, the fullback, who's been dangerous with the ball when we've seen her use it, but she hasn't been slotting in a great deal. She does lose it in contact. Somehow rescued there by the prop forward, Lenora Duhart. And Ferguson dives over there. She takes it. And all about not enough players coming in to just clear out, and a lot of players just searching for the ball. In the end, I think Winona State might have liked to have seen DeMars or Wilcox get in and just put a shoulder to someone.
There is a resetting the scrum. If you're liking this collegiate action, there's more national championship actions headed to the South. Wake Med Soccer Park in Cary, North Carolina. It's going to host 60 of the best collegiate rugby sevens programs at College Sevens this Memorial Day weekend. You can learn more about it at usarugby.org.
And that ball comes almost through the tunnel and out the Winona State side. So craziness going on between these two hookers. And there's the break up the middle. There goes Wolf. Wolf is looking for her support. She's got Hannigan. Can Hannigan get her second? Another offload, down to the line, the pickup, the dive, the try, Winona State, huge, huge try for the Black Cats.
Hannigan's certainly the finishing hero so far. Got that first try early on, not quite sure who was able to actually get that dive over the line yet. We'll take 1 second look.
I think that may have been Laken Esters running in support. She dished that off to Megan Wolf. Wolf did all that work with the run, and again, Esters was there with the catch and the pass again. Gotta love it when somebody just catches and passes. And yes, it definitely was Laken Esters doing the passing and doing the forward work of getting to the ruck and picking up and diving over.
Such a diverse array of skills on display there, too. That was some great running forward, good evasive maneuvers, beautiful passing work, and then catching just to finish it. And then really just diving outstretched, that beautiful score, the try technique by Laken Esters. Such a great player. Fantastic effort, too, for Winona State. If you're Davenport at this moment, you're saying, this is where it counts right now. We have to make a momentum shift occur, because right now the Black Cats are in the driver's seat.
And the kick is good. That ties the game. 12-12. And I have to say that I am very impressed with Laken Esters and her ability to get involved in a movement three times and really just touch the ball for maybe a second and a half total.
Certainly the depth of her game could be attributed to she's a Midwest Thunderbird, to such a great program for a number of these Black Cats as well, in both 15s and 7s. So can certainly play both creeds of the game.
Midwest Thunderbirds, they go on tours, collegiate level, under 20 level. They really try to make that select side experience work for them. Retained, the kickoff is retained by Davenport. Ferguson picks it up off her boot tops, and she's going through three or four players. Quick ball, this works well for Davenport. Burge picks it up off the bounce, out to Mayer. Mayer's been running the ball a couple of times. Telescam drops it off to Midzelic, and she is dropped summarily by Nassif. 7-on-3, big loopy pass, Ferguson has it. She's met by Carrie Jordan. Jordan kind of drags her down. Good defense from Winona State, but penalty finally, not rolling away from the ball. Trying too hard again to poach it rather than just reset and defend. And Katie, I'm not sure if the hawking on the ball is really working for Winona State at this time.
It's just, again, that a little bit over-aggressiveness around there. Ooh. Oh, so close to keep that ball in. Just put her foot on the line there. So certainly see a bit of frustration in her face.
They had it all set up. They knew what they wanted to do, and Emily Cron wanted to keep it in, but instead just... You see how Ferguson is just sort of challenging those defenders. Takes him a while, but right over the ball. No real attempt to support herself, and I think that was Wilcox who dove over. So the win, the lineout win for Davenport, they've got it. They're mauling it now. This looks very dangerous. They go down to the ground. There's a stretch over. Is that Meyer? That's a try.
That's fantastic set piece work there, too. Great lineout taken in, and then beautifully set up an orchestrated maul. Just went through the corner. Not much you can do when that maul starts moving forward.
Well, it split off into two pieces, and the important thing was that the piece that was in front was the one with the ball, and that indeed was Julia Meyer, the captain, blindside flanker, and you saw how there Meyer had it. Burst through, just on the line, stretches over, touches it down. Great work, and that's not easy to do, to hold that ball in one hand, especially for the women who usually have slightly smaller hands, to cradle it that way and touch it down with control.
Just great poise there to just get that outstretched arm over. Fantastic effort too. Just going that little extra inch just to get the job done for her team.
That's an important captain's try, and twice now we've seen, Katie, a try from Winona State, and immediately Davenport comes back down and scores as an answer.
And Myers is her second year as the team captain too. She's originally from Grand Rapids, Michigan. Also a family law major.
And see how they set that maul. And Katie, they got everybody in on this one.
Their Winona is doing whatever they can to try to bring it down. And that is brilliantly well worked to just split off from it and then went for that corner. Nice work there by Meyer.
On defense, you gotta get low. If they're getting low, get under that ball. Kickoff goes over Meyer's head and it rolls into touch. And so that'll work out quite nicely for Winona State. It'll be a Davenport lineout, but deep inside their 22. It is 17-12, Davenport leads in a game that is probably as close as either one of them have had for any of their league games. And I don't see any panic. I see two teams that seem to be relishing this kind of competitive experience.
Well, there certainly is a great deal of time. We're about 26 minutes left on the clock, too. And just down by a try, there is no instance for panic, too. If you just keep your composure, certainly Winona State very much still in this game.
Tennant going into contact. Ferguson. Ferguson passes it. Burge. Burge has been very active, but she may have lost this one in the ruck. Nope. Dug out by Telescan. Passes, but it was kind of a pass to nobody. Rescued Ordway. Does very, very well, but still Davenport stuck well inside their 22. penalty, though, against Winona State. And once again, Katie, a little bit frustrating, I would think, for the Winona State coaching staff, because the team is defending perfectly well. They have no need to commit that infraction in the ruck.
It's just a matter of discipline at this point, too. Just knowing when to back off slightly, get yourself in better defensive position, or when to just really concede and make sure that you can fan out, do something else defensively besides give away the penalty.
Trust is a big part of this game, and trusting your defensive structure is part of it. Winona State has good defensive structure, and they had Davenport pinned in. The kick didn't go very far, though, so still Davenport has a lot of work to do to get out of this hole.
Donahue well taken in the lineout.
Burge, Tennant, Ferguson again lining up in the midfield. She's used as sort of a battering ram, a crash ball. Meyer, she makes good ground. Burge, fake, back through. Ashley Burge, she's got one to beat. She's dragged down from behind, though. Anybody with her?
Beautiful pickup on that errant pass as well.
And yes, in from the side. This wasn't really the tackler who came in from the side to steal that ball. So a penalty against Winona State once again for a ball-stealing infraction.
Penalty starting to become an issue here for the Black Hats. But just great individual effort there by Burge. Great example of attentional focus. She kept her eyes focused on the ball as it was bouncing towards her. She was able to maintain possession and then went forward. Not a lot of great evasive maneuvers there, too. Here she is with the pickup. Oh, man, that's great strides going forward. She misses one tackle, two. They're trying to chase her down. Okay. Uses that great sidestep in good position there, too, and draws the penalty.
Well, the tackler there was Catherine Dries, but I think it was more a case of she hadn't really released the ball carrier. There, holding on, clear holding on. Lenora Duhart was on that ball very quickly. Taps and goes, and the prop forward has Winona State back on the attack.
Great strength to keep her feet there so her support could come knocking.
DeMars, the hooker. And now the pickup by Bucky. Wilcox goes in there to fix that.
Fantastic extra effort by Wilcox to secure ball.
Nassif, who was on the academic honor roll, but not too smart by the rest of the team as there's a holding on penalty and kind of sealing off. And now we're going to have a discussion. As you predicted, Katie Wurst, Khalil Harrison, the referee, says probably no more. Kind of tired of this. You've got to allow the other team to play some rugby. We are having too many penalties in the ruck. And Winona State mostly guilty of diving onto the ball while trying to poach it.
Unfortunate end to that. Really beautiful sequence of some great pick and go forward rugby. Just held on just a little bit too long. Maybe just outpaced the support. If you're sure of that support, then certainly that will reduce those holding on penalties.
Well, I think it's also a case, as the kick goes to touch and the lineup for Davenport, also a case of if you're playing games that are not as competitive as this one, you're used to going into a breakdown situation when there's no support there while you steal the ball. That's a little bit different than when you get there and there are people trying to clear you out. Suddenly, you're in a situation where you're trying to poach the ball when you shouldn't be. And the throw in from Weber, substitute hooker for Davenport, is not straight.
That was well identified, too, by the Black Hats there. They saw a bit of movement, opted not to contest in air.
And you see,
I think it threw off the throw a bit.
Whenever they catch it with that outside hand, that's going to be called not straight. That's a good throw from Hill. And the maul is set by Winona. Ripped out. Hill. Hill's all alone on the left side. She has one player to beat. She goes on the outside. She's not taken down. To the line, try. Fantastic try from Winona State. They are rightly jubilant on that one and has set that maul. She ripped it around. She looked like she looked like she was just sort of out to buy herself a popsicle or something, and she wasn't really doing anything special, and she just kept going.
Hill, just fantastic confidence, too. You see her just get that ball at the back. It was well taken out here. She's just, and here's another look, just her striding upfield, and then she's got one player to beat, too. Good little maneuver there. Nice evasiveness. You see one more defender coming over. She commits, gets herself to the ground, and touches the ball down, too. But really, off the back of that lineout, well worked. They weren't really going too many places, and it was at least one of her locks, likely Kavanitz, who actually stripped the ball back, and then she just did a great job to see, look up and have some field awareness to see that there was no defensive threats in front of her. She saw nothing but green space, and she went for it. Fantastic job to finish by Hill. Exactly what this Black Cats team needed.
And the kick is up, but a little bit to the right, so it'll stay 17-17. A nice little change of direction right at the end by Hill to get around O'Connor, the fullback, who is the last line of defense. And she's not a big player, is the scrum half, Kayleen Hill, but she threw in the line out. Nice win, as you see. Yeah, I think you're right, Kavanish was the one who made it available to her. And then Hella, just think about going inside, then go outside. And O'Connor kind of dove a little bit early. She protected the ball well enough to score.
That's a scrum half's dream opportunity there,
really
too.
Is.
Just getting the ball off the back and seeing nothing but daylight. Really takes a great deal of confidence to step up and make it happen.
And the ball nudged forward by Kavanich on the kickoff, so it'll be a scrum for Davenport. Also an issue there, they just had a switch at hooker. And while the starting hooker, who's Veronica Overbeek, is still on the field, they now have a change as to who is playing the hooker role. And when your hooker gets sucked into that maul on a lineout, that leaves that weak channel open. And it was wide open for Kayleen Hill on that one. We have a little bit less than 20 minutes to go here in this final here at the USA Rugby Division II Fall Championship for Women. 17-17, Davenport in red, Winona State in the purple and yellow. I'm Alex Goff from Goff Rugby Report with USA Rugby coach, educator, Katie Wurst, here at Furman University. And the ball squirts out again, some messy scrums. And Katie, we talked about Davenport being a strong scrum team, and they are. But Winona State has not backed down. They haven't given up or ceded the scrum. They've done whatever they can to try and make it work a little bit for them.
You see them just playing more with their head instead of their muscles as well, too. It's like trying to make some changes, small adjustments, and just playing a really intelligent scrum game here to try to offset their size advantage.
Big straight drive from Davenport. That's pretty impressive. But they don't win the ball. And it is kicked by Dries. O'Connor, she juggles it, but she has it. Nicely done by the fullback. And out to the wing, Taffel. Taffel is thumped to the ground. Davenport, slow to rescue this at the breakdown.
That was Megan Wolf on that solid hit. Taffel just ran into a brick wall.
Kavanich there for Winona State, trying to steal the ball, as was Duhart. We've called their names a couple of times, and the ball not coming out, and we end up with a scrum. There's a replacement now as Hannah DeMars, the hooker for Winona State, goes off. And I think we may see, might be Samantha Blair coming on, I'm not sure.
Good decision to get some fresh legs into this front row as well, too. DeMars just put in an excellent effort. So much work that they've had to do up front. Good call by Coach Krasinski.
A cleaner strike for Davenport, but it's Winona State putting on the shove, wheeling it around. Picked up by Moreland, dished off. And that's the winger, Taffel, Courtney Taffel, working her way down. The senior from Saginaw, Michigan. And the pass out, juggled, but rescued again. Midzelic.
Schultz was in on that try-saving tackle, fronting up.
Tellis can try to dig the ball out, but the ruck coming down and very messy. That was counter-rucking from Winona State, and it ended up being Ferguson trying to pick up quickly and go, and she knocked it on. So a scrum to Winona State. But what about that drive from the Black Cats? That kind of came out of nowhere.
Certainly, like we said, just trying to maneuver, make them work. If they've got more force and power, you're trying to just offset their balance too, which is a good decision. And again, a great tactical choice to make a substitution. It's really tough if you've been playing all game long and you've got a scrummage against a tough side, then bring somebody in who's fresh and just changes up the dynamic.
Again, a good hold by Winona State. Hill, well, she went around the left side. She's going to go around the right side this time, dishes it off. And I think that might be Bucky in support of her. And into touch, but made a good 30 meters on that run.
Critical at this point to keep the ball in the middle of the field, too, and then just kind of work that game plan and look for the strike points. Basically for both sides, but certainly for the Black Cats as well. Just getting them out of that danger zone.
The danger zone. Ball looks like a little bit of a not straight throw, but I think we are going to blow that up. And little things that are becoming sort of the bete noire for each team. And we talked about the breakdown penalties for Winona State. And for Davenport, their lineout throwing and securing that ball in contact. Too many knock-ons for them. It's been an issue as...
I think that was Jory Smith that just went off.
That's right. Jory Smith goes off, and Amy Plambeck, the sophomore, comes on and puts herself at the back of the line-out. And beautifully taken by Kavanich. And now they're working it. Dries trying to set up Esters. The ball was dropped backwards. It's kicked ahead. It's still alive. And this is Kron. Kron with a little bit of room. Cleared out. Nicely done. Nassif. And not releasing the tackle player. Kind of a clear penalty there by Davenport.
I think that was Burrs, too, just making the tackle, getting up a little too quick there.
There, and Tara Talahard, the former Indiana State High School All-Star, is on as a substitute, and she was a little bit over-eager as well. But you see that little loop, and that drop, that might have been thought of as a knock-on, but it was kicked ahead by Dries, and Kron had that run. I have a feeling she was a little shade offside on that kick, but... No call, might have been even looking at the camera angle, I'm not sure. So Hill now with a throw. She's been throwing very well. Kavanich, not a problem with that take. Hello, we've got that maul. Let's get that maul going. Oh, now we're going to spin off Wilcox this time. Quickly out from Hill.
That was Overbeek on that great tackle.
Esters. Esters looking for Wolf. She takes contact, popping it out there to Messer.
That's Ordway, I think, making that really striking tackle there. Such low body position when they're charged forward from this Winona State team.
Oh, they're slow, and that ball has been poached. And that is Tennant, the center, taking it. Meyer, the captain for Davenport, charging ahead. Are they going to kick? Are they going to try and run through? Looks like they're going to try and run their way out of that. That's Moreland, the number 8.
Was a bit isolated, but it was able to hold on.
Talahard passes it out. And not a great situation for Davenport. Loose pass. They're stuck back now. They're going backwards. This is what we talked about with Winona State. Their defense has been so good, they don't need to try and steal the ball.
Solid tackle right at the ankles there, too. They just keep the hits keep on coming here for Winona State.
Ferguson goes in. And again, good patience defense. Kavanich getting involved, as is Jordan, the prop for Winona State on the defense. And the penalty, finally, they went over and they dove over. And Davenport kind of was just hoping that was going to happen as they ran their players straight up. One pass and a run, maybe two passes, but they weren't going to get too fancy with it. Brenna Donahue at the bottom of that pile. And now Daniel Ordway, I think, will kick to touch, clear it a little bit. Lands right on somebody's backpack next to the production truck. And when looking how these teams got here, Davenport 43-26 against Bloomsburg, and they were down 26-5, so it was 38 unanswered points in the second half. And Winona State 45-26 over Vassar, and really that was a physical superiority as much as anything else in that game. And Bloomsburg beat Vassar today for third place. Oh, there's a break right now. Ordway, we haven't seen her in space much. She's gonna go by Schultz. Can she have the gas to go all the way? She is still running. One more to beat. She's gonna be able to get by, and Ordway goes all the way from deep inside her 22. Try for Davenport, and that came out of nowhere.
Well, that's just what pure speed looks like right there, and Ordway just a great, as you said, haven't seen her in space, and once that space offered, there's not much that Schultz can do when you're backpedaling, trying to get in better position. We knew that that was a danger that was lurking in the background, too. Great job distributing the ball, getting it wide, and she literally takes it out, runs the entire length of the field, essentially. One to beat there. Dust that one off, no problem. And even from this angle, you can see her all the way back. Fantastic job there by Danny Ordway. They don't call her Dash for nothing. Exceptional work. And really just a difficult blow there for Winona State, who defended so beautifully for the entire length of the several phases that we had before. Right now they have to regroup, take a moment and say, hey, we can just shove that one off and let's make sure we go back to our game plan. We'll get possession of the ball. As soon as we have the ball, keep it in touch and we'll see what we can go with.
Well, Katie, that was about the first time in about 30 minutes that Davenport had actually executed the lineout as the kick goes over to make it 24-17. And once they won a lineout, it's such a great attacking platform. It was hands out. And you saw that Ordway made that fake, opened up the hole, and then cut around Schultz. Schultz made that one diving grasp, and Hill was still in chase, as was Kron, right to stop her from going around underneath the post. That was the best that they could do.
Tough one for Moreland to handle there, too. A really great position opportunity here for Winona State. If they want to answer, now's the time.
Well, we've been waiting to see Ordway score. She's been scoring somewhere in the neighborhood of 6 tries a game in the playoffs, 5 yesterday, in fact, and really hadn't seen her do much.
She does it often in red, white, and blue jersey as well, too, as part of the All-American system.
And there's the Dries loop, trying to work Wolf into it. She's there, but she is so isolated, manages to roll the ball back, so well picked up. Winona State still has the ball. Referee
critical
calling,
turnover.
I think, maybe an advantage here for offside. Again, the pick and go, and referee Harrison says, not rolling away. The tap by Duhart. Duhart, another player we saw a lot of yesterday. Penalty advantage again, not 10 is Davenport. So can Winona State answer immediately? They're right on the line. Now it's slow coming out. The backs want it, the backs have space, but you think it's gonna be a little bit of white line fever here. And now we go, the backs. Esters, Wolf, Wolf, she's there. Right back down. Winona State Black Cats make it a 2-point game, 24-22. We've got the kick to come. And Katie, what a great answer.
Oh, fantastic. They certainly did answer the call, too. We heard them talk about it's about heart right now, and they certainly have a great deal of it here as the Black Cats find a try to just really put them back on their heels and say, oh, hold on. There's so much time left here. We've got a good 7 minutes. It's such a, been a fantastic ball game that we've seen here. And really
kick.
That was Wolf, just the back line. It's such a brilliant decision as well, too, to take it wide. Really just unselfish play, too, as well. Forwards trying to charge it in. You saw them just suck in that defense, and they had all the space outside. Good distribution, and Wolf was able to finish it off.
Big smile from the Oshkosh, Wisconsin native. She knows how important that is. This is important too, the kick. And Dries puts it. The direction is good, but the height wasn't there. And you see now the back line move, and Wolf just cut back right into some contact, but right on the line as well, as close to the post as she could get. Punches the air with her fist. Happy, but it is a 24-22 lead for Davenport with that phenomenal kick from Hannah Tennant. I think that's who kicked it. It might have been Ordway to kick that conversion for Davenport. 24-22 with about 6 minutes to go.
Winona State needs to really take care of the ball here on this restart.
And just as you say that, Katie Wurst, they do not. Carrie Jordan would like that back, like another shot at it. But she thought about catching and running and just sort of smacks her head a little bit. A little bit frustrated. But at this point, you cannot give any team an extra chance. And both of these teams have been giving their opposition extra chances.
Important to shake that one off too. Still got time. And just what matters most after a mistake is how you counter.
Good shove from Davenport. Burge right behind. Tennant looking for Ordway. Now they're going to run a play. They get O'Connor involved. O'Connor is just brought down. Not a problem for the defense of Winona State, but recycle quickly. You see the forwards are skating back in. Ferguson, she's all alone. Good clear out now from her support. Out to Midzelic. Midzelic brought down well. Ankle tackle. And now we look left. Burge to Tennant. Tennant is met summarily by Kron and pushed back. Nicely done by the wing from Winona State. But is there space out on the wing now for Davenport? Certainly looks like it. And Lindsay Buckey, the flanker, does what a good flanker is supposed to do. Gets out to where there's a gap and makes the tackle. We'll take a little bit of moment as a player is down on the field there. And that is Davenport wing Courtney Taffel, the sports management major from Saginaw, Michigan.
Buckey certainly lived up to the mascot there, jumped on him like a wild cat, and really had her move backwards, which is exactly what Winona State needs to do. And we'll take a minute then just to address an athlete that's down, to thank World Rugby Shop, which is proud to be the official online retailer of USA Rugby. You can get all your USA Eagles gear and more at worldrugbyshop.com.
Well, back on the line out now with Winona State. And it's stolen by Davenport. Donahue took that. Up ahead goes Ferguson again. And Talahard gets it out. She's digging for it. But they've lost it in contact. They've lost it illegally. And once again, a ruck penalty for Winona State. This time, perhaps it was the right time to think about stealing the ball when you're defending that long. But it's also opening up another scoring opportunity for the Panthers and another opportunity to just work the time down. Davenport wisely calls for a scrum. It takes a long time to get that together. They can drive with it, and certainly, Katie, I think we're going to see a nice shove put on.
And it, as you said, great decision just to expend the seconds on the clock, too. Every tick just spends away the currency that they have to stay in this game.
And there it is, the reset. Anything like a reset? Well, that's good news for Davenport. 24-22, we have about 3 minutes or so left. 3 minutes on the stadium clock. But of course, referee Khalil Harrison keeps the official time. And we have had one or two little stoppages. Not many, though.
Panthers smartly taking their time to set the scrum.
And Moreland picks it up, looking for Burge, but Moreland's going to run. She's going to run through, and she just lost the ball. Her pocket was picked and went down, and then holding on immediately. Hannah Tennant was right on that tackle, right on her opposite number, Lake and Esters, and Tennant forced Esters to hold on, and another penalty. So now they call for a shot at goal, and once again, Katie, this serves two purposes.
Such a series of emotions there between Moreland coming at you and then Esters picking her pocket to come back to then give up the penalty. And now here, a great smart decision to just take some time off the clock, put a couple more points out, distancing themselves ahead.
It would require Winona State to score a try to tie it. The kick by Tennant is up, and it is good. We've got about 90 seconds left, and that makes it 27-22. Davenport leads.
Still enough time, certainly, to have a good restart, get the ball back quickly.
Well, they do it quickly. That's a quick restart. It's lost forward. It's gathered right there by Tron. And very wisely, after the ball was bounced off a Davenport player, the rest of the Davenport players left it alone, did not commit a penalty. You hear one of the players yelling, "Everything you have, let's give it." We've got a substitute coming in. Meanwhile, a referee asks for a little bit of assistance on the call. Ends up being a knock-on against Davenport. And Brittany McLean comes in on the wing for Winona State. And you wonder if maybe she immediately will be asked to do something.
If ever there was a time to get the ball out quick in the scrum and let the back lines do what they've been doing all weekend, absolutely get the ball out wide.
It really comes down to this. Loose ball, all craziness. Dries and McLean try to fix it. Ferguson just surging in there along with Talahard. But it's a knock on again by Davenport and another shot at it. So that one struck through and came through the legs of Bucky.
Great opportunity to learn from what just happened, make a slight adjustment, set your feet a bit better, and make sure you can get this pass off.
16 players just putting everything they can into that drive, and the scrum just disintegrates. A couple of players roll over onto their heads. Hopefully nobody gets hurt on that one. That can be very difficult. Everybody gets back on their feet, and that's good news. We're going to reset that scrum.
Prime example of the pressure that's been being exerted all game long, too, in this scrummaging battle.
You know that Davenport just wants to put a drive on this one. And well held by Winona State. Dries sending it out to Esters. Dries looped with her. Now Wolf. Wolf taken down. Bucky straight ahead. Nobody wants to give up a penalty here. All alone, that looks like Jordan.
Support came to rescue there.
Well cleared out.
Duhart's going to need some help as well, too.
Nassif comes in, but it is a penalty holding on. Duhart was pretty much alone, isolated, happens so often, and there is a penalty against Winona State. Will that be it? The kick to touch, referee, and that's going to be it. Davenport University wins the championship 27-22 against Winona State, thanks to a back-breaking long-range try from Dash Ordway. They finally won a line out, and they scored from long range, and Katie Wurst, Winona State, put everything they had into it.
Certainly, you can say that both sides have absolutely done everything they possibly can to come away victorious. The actual scoreboard slanted in favor of Davenport this time around, but Winona State certainly keep their heads held high. Down to the last second, they were charging on attack, but Davenport really just the victors on the day, thanks to so much athleticism, great talented team play, and a good effort here. And congratulations there, too, to the national champions, Davenport University.
Well, they showed an awful lot of fortitude to Davenport. Twice Winona State scored against them, and Davenport turned around and went right back down to score again. We talked about yesterday how they were down 26-5 at halftime and completely turned it around 38-0 in the second half to win that game. They used their forwards. They used their scrum. Their scrum was superior, but Winona State didn't capitulate in the scrum. And you see how the players are celebrating now. And they will be getting their medals and their trophy. Winona State Black Cats should not be dejected by their performance. Obviously, they felt they could have won it. I think they could have. And they didn't find a solution to the penalties they were giving up, especially defensively in the ruck. And suitably enough, really, the game ends on a penalty in the breakdown because they just kept giving up those penalties.
Well, they certainly showed a great deal of heart here. Again, contesting to the last second. And Davenport, you see them just having a moment, too, to thank the fans that have come out here. And we'll let some of these images now just do the talking for us.
And there you see the big hits that are going on. This was a very physical game. It was a game where both teams played defensively. In fact, we didn't see any points scored until 20 minutes in. And look at the ball movement by the back line from Winona State.
That was Megan Wolf, just a hard charger all game, getting that ball out to Hannigan.
Congratulations again to Davenport and Coach Greg Tillazon.
And there you see then Esther's coming in support to pick up and dive over. That was a crucial one. And then the drive.
You can hear in the background as Davenport just celebrating their win here. Taking a look at a critical part there was that outstretched arm, putting the ball down. Just fantastic technique to finish the job.
Captain Julia Meyer scoring that try off the back of the maul. Gave them a little bit of thought, but then there was this one off the back of a maul and a long way from the try line, but scrum half Kayleen Hill beating the last two cover defenders. Superb run. And there they are, champions, Davenport Panthers. It says on the screen Winona State, but this is Davenport who are champions, 27-22 over Winona State. And there's the captain, Julia Meyer, led that team. So many hard yards she got, but also she scored a critical try as well.
And there was also a shot there, too, of Danny Ordway. Just really, that was the try that broke Winona State's back. They're just such an exceptional long field. She ran the whole distance of the pitch, too, to finish it. Just such a well-deserved individual effort there, too. But such a team player, too, linking so many times with Burge and a number of other players. Moreland was such a critical player that launched attack so many times for the Panthers.
So Davenport University are the champions. Winona State University you're looking at right now with runners up. They played so well. They looked so impressive against Vassar. And this game could have gone either way. It was 24-22 with just a few minutes to go. When Hannah Tennant kicked that penalty to make it just a little bit more of a cushion. All right, we're going to be looking at an interview here with one of the stars of the game, Danny Ordway, the outside center. And Danny, how does it feel?
It feels awesome to get this far. We've worked so hard every day. I mean, we've been practice daily, 5 days a week. Do we do double workouts? It's just amazing to get this far. And
well,
getting the loss last year really hurt us, so we wanted it really bad this year.
You scored that long-range try, and Daniel, you had many tries over the playoff run. You scoring four or five, six tries in a game. This time it was just the one, but how big a try was it for you?
I would say that was a huge try because she took the fake on our pack member back inside. It was a long run, and we really needed that to boost our confidence up just to give us a little bit more comfort in the game, and I really think that changed the momentum for us.
And talk a little bit also about the forward platform, because they won that lineout for you to get that try, but also the forwards have done so much work in the scrums, in the mauls. What is it like to be in the back line behind that kind of forward pack?
It's really amazing because we are confident in them to win their scrums and win their lineouts. They're a really tough pack to go against. I won't want to be with them, I can tell you that much.
Well, it's a team effort all the way. Congratulations, Daniel Ordway and Davenport. Terrific job.
Thank you very much.
And that is Daniel Ordway, Dash Ordway, the outside center for Davenport. She scored that one try. That's all she needed to do. We're not done with rugby here today. We have two more games for you, and next up, the Division I Fall Championship between UConn and Air Force. Kickoff will be at 1 o'clock. Stay here at USA Rugby TV for that. I'm Alex Goff with Katie Wurst. We'll be back with the Division I Women's Fall Championship at 1 o'clock.